Sam here from Sheridan Computers. In this video, I'm going to walk through how you replace a failed hard drive in a TrueNAS boot pool. When you install TrueNAS, it gives you the option to install the base operating system over a couple of drives. This is for redundancy in case one of those drives fails, you're still able to boot into TrueNAS. But if one of those drives fails, what do you do next? Well, you need to replace the drive and you need to rebuild that boot pool. So I'm going to show you how to do that. Before I do, if you'd like to hire us, head across to our website at sheridan.co.uk and click on that Hire Us button. If you do find this video useful, please hit that like button and consider subscribing to the channel. And if you hit the notifications icon, you'll receive notifications of any new videos as they are released. So let's head over to TrueNAS and take a look at what we need to do. In the TrueNAS dashboard, you can see we have a notification. Now this notification is going to be the fact that one of the drives has failed. I know this because I've just pulled the power out of the back of it. And if you look what it says, critical boot pool status is degraded. One or more devices have been removed by your administrator. Sufficient replicas exist for the system to continue functioning, but it's degraded, so we need to replace that drive. And if we head across to storage, disks, you see that the drive is now missing. So I'm going to go ahead and replace it with a different drive. Okay, so I pulled the drive. I'm not on a hot swap system, so I also pulled the power to the system, and we have a notification saying it's had an unscheduled reboot. That's fine, it's because I pulled the power from that. So what we're going to do next is we're going to go ahead and we're going to look at the storage, and we're going to go to disks. So this is a drive that I've replaced. Now, I knew which drive that I had to replace anyway, because I pulled the power out of it. But TrueNAS does make this quite easy for you by giving you the serial number of the drive. So you can always find it that way. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the drive. I'm going to hit wipe. This will just make sure the drive's... hit that confirm icon button. So this will wipe the disk and make sure that the drive's all ready for TrueNAS as we want it. So now we need to go into system. Boot, and we're going to go to, so you can see our boot environments. We've got the initial install, we've got the current one. So we're going to go to actions, and we're going to go to boot pool status. So it says, as you can see, we've got the ADA0, which is still online, and that's why the system's running. But the drive that we pulled has been removed. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and click that, and then we're going to hit replace. Now this stage, it will give us the option of which disk we want to replace it with. Now these are all appearing because I've got a bunch of drives in here that are not used. So ADA1 was the one that I replaced, and we're going to go ahead and hit submit. Okay, so we've told it what we want to do. So you can see we've got a mirror which just contains ADA0. We've got replacing, and on the left we've got dev ADA1 /old, and we've got dev ADA1 for the new one. So now we just need to go ahead and wait for that to rebuild. And once it's rebuilt, we can carry on using the system. It's quite that easy to replace a drive. So that's completed, and our boot pool is now healthy and back online. So I'm going to go and do this just one more time. So I've whipped the drive out and I put the original one back in, and you'll notice boot pool status is degraded. One or more devices cannot be used because the label is missing or invalid. So this is because I've replaced it with the drive that was already a member of the boot pool. So I'm going to go into system, boot pool status. And as you can see, this one that I've replaced it, which was the original one, says faulted. I'm going to go ahead and detach that. So device is now detached. We go into storage, disks, and now we can go in and wipe that drive. Let's go ahead and wipe it. So we wiped, so now we can go back into system, boot, take a look at the boot pool status again. It's online, but it's only got one drive on it because I removed one. So we're going to want to attach. I'm going to stick in the original one that we removed. Submit. And device was attached successfully. So now if we go into Bootpool's status, it's online. We've got another notification. The Bootpool status is online. One or more of the devices is currently being resilvered. The pool will continue to function, possibly in a degraded state. So I had to detach it because it was already a member of that boot pool when I pulled it out and then replaced it with the one and put it back. So that's why we did that. So it is quite easy to do that, and ZFS is pretty fault tolerant, to be honest. So if there's interest on me on how to do it in a storage pool, I'll do that. Please leave it in the comments below if you want me to do that. I hope you found this video useful. Like I said at the beginning of the video, if you'd like to hire us, go ahead to our website and click on that hire us button. Please hit that like button if you found this useful. It does help with the YouTube algorithms. Consider subscribing to our channel and hit them notifications icons, and you'll get the notifications of any new videos that we do. See you in the next video.